educational process for these graduates. I'm not in the classroom very much. My interactions are in the hallway or in the lunchroom or in the morning before school. Through the course of the past year, I've been around some of our seniors a little more in the world of athletics. They're in basketball season. I drove on the buses to the away games. As an assistant baseball coach, I drove the bus plenty this last fall and spring. It was in this environment where I got to see these students or seniors in a little different light. They have an extreme love of music. Some of it is music that I have no idea about. Some of it is songs that I can get behind. But they have a love of music. Whether it's Brandon starting off a song on the bus, or in the summertime when Jason went to work for school, come around the corner, you can hear Jay singing Christmas music. So today, because of their love of music, I want to share my wishes for the day through music. And no, I'm not going to sing. As a parent and as an educator, the words to a particular song seem to ring true as the wishes for us, for our children, or our students. I'm going to share a song with you today, a song by Bob Dylan. It's titled Forever Young. It goes like this. May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always live for others and let others live for you. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung, and may you stay forever young. May you grow up to be righteous. May you grow up to be true. May you always know the truth and see the light surrounding you. May you always be courageous, stand upright, and be strong, and may you stay forever young. May your hands always be busy. May your feet always be swift. May you have a strong foundation when the winds and changes shift. May your heart always be joyful, and may your song always be sung, and may you stay forever young. I'll leave it up to you if you want to move it or not. Again, these lyrics embody my hopes for each of you as you head out on the next part of your journey. I want to thank your parents for allowing us to be a part of your lives. Congratulations.
Rachel, family, and friends. Good afternoon. Brashear High School graduating class of 2022. Doesn't that far grow feel good? I want you to know that I consider it my privilege to have had you in my classroom as students. It has been my great joy to get to know you as well. I'm honored that you're willing to listen to me one last time. Before you arrive,
demonstrate a work ethic that many of your age don't have. Take your credit.
I've enjoyed your sense of humor, Diagram. I admire how you are always courteous and polite. You are someone I can always depend on. Kimberly, you have such a fun personality. I enjoy talking with you and hearing your stories, and they always start something like this. So, here's what was going on. Just recently, you and I were talking about track. You told me that you wanted to be in track because it's your senior year, but you really didn't want to run, sweat, and have sore muscles. But you wanted to be in track. I feel like you see the value of every moment, and you're willing to give it all you have. Mr. McHenry told me how you all want to have a last word. Mrs. Reese gets it today. She asked me to say one last time. Jason, let me take your hat off. Just a few weeks ago, Mrs. Baker brought us an old wooden spring horse that she and Mr. Dillon used to make an archway for Grand Arch. I thought it was a lovely horse, and she and I had a conversation about those doors. We talked about the people who had walked in and out of them, children who ran against them, pressing their hands on the screen. The stories that those doors might tell, think of. I thought I'd say another prayer again, because I want to talk to you about doors. You heard me right. I'm not practicing for a summer job with other people, but I really am going to talk to you about doors, literally and figuratively. To begin, come on in. The door's open. When you hear this, you may think of your grandparents' home or your friend's house, or you just walk in without knocking. These are the places where people love you, as you are, support you, are always there for you. You're sitting on this front row today, and I think you should be proud. The world's already done. You didn't get here all on your own. There are many people who love to make this happen. They are your parents, your family, your friends, your teachers, your coaches, your preacher, this entire community. This community truly is special. We see it often in the way it honors and helps its members. Some of you are in a hurry to move on. Don't forget where you came from. If you ever need anything, this community will be the first to say, come on in. For an open door of opportunity. Opportunities are sometimes often they are earned. They have to be made. You have to say to yourself, I want this. Therefore, I'm going to prepare for this. I'm going to work toward this. And then when this opportunity arrives, it can be mine. You have so many opportunities right now. You just have to be willing to make the course. I know this. Already, you have bills to pay for the people paying into insurance. You have lifestyles to maintain if you ask God. You may even be paying your own way entirely. Because of this, you may think that you don't have all the options. You don't have to do. I understand feeling like that, but you need to think of the possibilities. Sometimes we set our own parameters, and in doing so, we limit ourselves. Set out to do the things that challenge you, even the things you are afraid of doing. You don't want to look back in 5 years, or when you're 30 years old and realize you missed an opportunity, where you are right now. Just that high school has unlimited opportunities. Make one of them yours. In real estate, they say to always keep the front door spotless. It's the first impression of the house. We can think of this front door. Reputation. For every one of us, our reputation goes before us. You have a record already of how the people describe you. Make sure you are living just like you want to be known. Keep yourself clean. Hold yourself to a higher standard. At some point, I'm sure you all heard, close the door before you are. There are times when you need to close the door. Close the door to protect you from what's on the other side. Don't let the door hit you on the way out. There are always some people who need to walk out the door and but stay in situations that are bringing you down. There are paths that will only lead to heartache, and you need to get out of them. You may get more slammed in the face. You'll work hard and deserve the job and recognition, and yet not get it. You may be treated in ways that you don't deserve. I'm sorry to say this happens too often. That's the doors slammed. But when one door closes, another door opens. Change is always hard to change. You have to learn new things. Change often means you need to work on you. Change brings new possibilities, new opportunities. Don't be afraid to step through the new open door. In the Bible, Matthew chapter 7, verses 7 and 8, say, ask, and it shall be given you. For everyone that asks, it receives, and he that seeks finds, and then knocks, it shall be opened. Keep knocking. Don't give up. Diligence is not a diligence. Don't do something you want and think it's good enough. Hardly ever is good enough. Be diligent. You hear people who become overnight successes, and please do think, oh, they have all the right words. They do the right people.
Three adult children, and the fourth one being close.
along with good memories, I hope they learn something from me. Even though I think they say to the parents, I hope I've taught them the things that they need to know. I know how rich they make my life. And how much I often learn from them and how I admire them. Through the years, my hopes for my children have changed. I just think I want to be the only kid in kindergarten and looking at
Adrian Michael Mason. White.
Thank you.
The Warlock TSC Foundation Scholarship for $1,950. True Merit Scholarship for Truman for $2,000. The President's Honorary Scholarship for Truman for $1,500. True Opportunity Scholarship for Truman for $2,000. The Academic Excellence Award for Northwest Missouri State University for $3,000. Access Extra Scholarship, Missouri Scholarship Foundation for $2,000. The Brashear Memorial Scholarship for $500. The Golden Globe Scholarship for $500. The BBC Volunteer and Service Scholarship for Brashear Booster Club for $500. The Kelly Chess Scholarship for $1,000. The Herdman 4th of July Scholarship for $250. She's the alternate to the Olene Pendleton Memorial Scholarship for $500. She's the alternate to the Carol Chambers Memorial CTA Scholarship for $300. Sierra is also receiving the George Washington Parker Award, the President's Award for Outstanding Excellence, a College Preparatory Study Certificate, and the A-Plus Scholarship Award.
Especially
unstoppable. I speak for all of us when I say it can always come to us, any one of us, if you need to talk. We'd be happy to help. All year, I have told Ed to give each of you some encouraging words. The time to make the time. But in the interest of being through my reader process of not writing a book, I would love to give them to you now.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the sixth grade class of 2022.
Thank you. Thank you.